Assalamu alaikum guys, in today's video I'm going to give you quick introduction of 8 parts of speech. In following video you will learn about parts of speech in more detail. So first of all I'll tell you what are parts of speech. A name given to a word based on its job in a sentence. Parts of speech can be a job type, like a person can be a lawyer, teacher or engineer. The word can be an adjective, verb or adverb depending on a job that it does in a sentence. These things can be really useful to learn because when you study in grammar, you will come across terms like noun, pronoun, verb, adverb and other parts of speech. If you know what they really mean, they can help you to speed up your studies. So guys, first of all, I'll tell you what is speech. Whatever we talk is called a speech. The speech consists of parts or words. Now move to parts of speech. The classes into which words are divided according to their grammar are called parts of speech. The parts of speech are 8 in number, and if we include an article then they will be 9. So first one is noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction and interjection. Now guys, first of all we'll talk about noun, the first part of speech. A noun is a name of person, place, thing, animal, feeling or idea. Like king, Lahore, hate, love, all these are example of noun. Here I have written a couple of example. The first one is she likes plants and animals. You can see guys in this sentence, in this example, plants and animals both are name of something, that's they are called noun. Look at second example. Hamid went to Mali on vacation with his family last year. Students, in one sentence there will be more than one or two noun. You can see in this sentence the first noun is Hamid because it's the name of a person. Second is Mali because it's the name of some place. Vacation is a type of trip that people take, that's why it's also called noun. Next one is family. Family is a group of people like mother, father, daughter, sister, okay, etc. This is called family. And the last noun in this sentence is year. And you know, this is a period and a year consists of 365 days. Now guys, move to second part of speech, and that is pronoun. First of all, I'll tell you the definition of pronoun. What is pronoun? The word which is used in place of a noun to avoid its repetition is called pronoun. You can see here I have written few example. He, she, it, I, you. These are the word which we use at the replacement of noun. Now look at the sentence. Sara is at the movie with her friend. They enjoy a lot. Students, here I have used they at the replacement of Sara and her friend. So we can say that pronoun is a word which we use to replace a noun to avoid repetition and to make our speech sound more appealing and natural. Now guys, move to third part of speech, and that is adjective. Adjective give information about noun and pronoun. So we can say that a word that qualifies and adds to the meaning of a noun or pronoun is called adjective. Here I have written one example. I saw a strange hen. So in this sentence, strange is adjective. And guys, one thing more about adjective, keep in your mind. We have to write adjective before a noun, like ugly face, black shirt or pretty girl. Now guys, we will talk about a verb. A word that expresses an action, movement or existence about the subject, noun or pronoun is called verb. Like fly, do, ride, come, etc. Now look here. Ali plays tennis 3 times in a week. Students, in this sentence, play is verb of someone. And in second example, I am a teacher. Students, you can see in first sentence there is a physical action, but in second sentence there is not physical action. It's a state or situation which expresses what I am. So we can say that here play is a physical verb, but here am is situation. And you know am is a helping verb or auxiliary verb. So guys, we can say that verbs are probably the most important word in the English language that has two reasons. Every sentence in English must has verb. Only verb has tense like present, past and future, in which we talk about different times and to do that we change the forms of verb. Now guys, we will talk about the fifth part of speech, and that is adverb. An adverb is a word which adds to the meanings of a verb, an adjective or another adverb, like happily, low, slowly, fast and etc. So we can say that adverb give information about verb, adjective or another adverb. Now look at the example. I have almost finished my work. In this sentence, almost is adverb. So guys, if I'll give you one more example. People shouted loudly and killed a beast promptly. In this sentence, the word loudly and promptly both are adverbs. So we can say that adverb tell us how the work is done in a sentence. Now guys, move to sixth part of speech, and that is preposition. First of all, I'll tell you what is preposition. A word or a group of words used before a noun or a pronoun to show place, position and method is called preposition. Such as in, on, at, by, from, with, before, after, out of, etc. All these are preposition. Now look at the example. This gift is to you from Aisha. You can see in this sentence there are two prepositions. The first one is to and second is from. So students, we can use simple or compound both preposition in a sentence to show place, position, time or method in a sentence. Now guys, we will talk about seventh part of speech, and that is conjunction. First of all, I'll tell you the definition of conjunction. The conjunction is a word which is used to connect words, phrases or sentences together, like either, and, but, or, because, etc. Now move to example. Zahid and Shahid are going to bazaar. In this sentence, I have used and to join to noun. So in this sentence, and is work as a conjunction. Now move to last part of speech, and that is interjection. Now question is here, what is interjection? An interjection is a word that expresses some sudden feeling or emotions. Some specific words we use to express our feeling and emotion. They don't have really meaning, but we use to show our sudden feeling or emotions in a sentence. Like, oh, hooray, ah, wow. Okay, such words are called interjection. So guys, keep one thing more in your mind. We have to put exclamation sign after writing conjunction. Here you can see I have written oh, and after writing oh, I have put here exclamation sign. So guys, in today's video we have discussed about the eight parts of speech: noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, preposition, conjunction and interjection. I hope your concepts will be cleared regarding all parts of speech. We will meet in next video. Till then, Allah Hafiz.